Well, welcome back to Steve Rob Reviews. As you can see behind me here, I got a couple of solar panels set up and I've changed the design quite a bit. I brought the whole system further down towards the ground. I'll show you that up close in a minute. And why I've done that, then I fabricated a whole bunch of assemblies to fasten these down with. And I'll tell you something, the design on these panels are just incredible. I like the way the system is. Of course, I never got the final connection to plug in to my service panel, but I ordered a new one. You'll see that in the future. And I have to solder a couple of pigtail ends on that they provided. And I'm going to show you how I solder it, and I don't think any of you guys do this. You might find it interesting, I'm not too sure, but we're going to go with it. So let's take a look at the panels and see what I've done that's made a big difference. Well, let's start off at the bottom here. You can see the clips I've added to the bottom here. I have to install this by myself more than likely. And the first panel, well, I don't want it sliding off and fooling around with it or anything else. Couple of easy clips, couple of rivets, and away you go. Now, originally I wanted 30 inches from the bottom, and it looks like I'm about 19 inches. And the original idea was to have spaces in between the panels so that the wind would blow through and this wouldn't act like a sail. Apparently that's not such a great idea to do, because in the winter time you'll have the snow come down and it'll just be a big blockage here and it will build up on there, which I thought made sense. So instead of me having the panels further up on the other side of this cross member, which is the just aft of center, I brought it the opposite direction. So I turned this around 180, and I just got some mock bolts in there for now, holding it in, and I'll show you underneath what it looks like and what I fabricated. Okay, if we take a look right here, I fabricated up these pieces of aluminum. They're 4 inches long, and I've got the bolts in there. This hole here came already on the panel, and if I can get you in behind there, you could see where I drilled a hole there. So this is all gonna match, and of course you're gonna have four of these assemblies on each panel. And I've got just a regular number 5 grade bolt, but I've got a stainless steel washer on this side, stainless steel washer on the inside here, and a galvanized bolt on the other side, and I will use Loctite on these. But that's the assembly there. Now I'll just show you some unique features of this panel that I thought are really nice. Okay, I'm on the bench over here and I'm getting ready to do some more soldering, but this is just one of them pieces there, very simple to do. And what I like about this setup is these connectors. They're weatherproof connectors with O-rings on them. And guys, that's the way to go, really. I mean, when I first were doing solar panels years ago, we just had to wire up our own wires and they just gave you two studs, a positive and a negative. But this system here is, I think this is the best way and the fastest. So I was left with, here's one of the, this is a negative cable. So I just got it attached to a roll of number 8. Now all the wiring on this is number 10, but I had some number 8, so I'm going with the number 8, and it's stranded as well. And so I made the connection right here, and I'll show you how I make these connections. I don't think you guys do this very often, or if not at all. But another thing I wanted to show you was you can test, oh by the way, here's all the painted bolts are going to go to hold that frame down. It's all done here. And I always like to test my panels before I actually put them in use, because you never know, maybe it's not working, right? And you can test them in your garage just with a regular light on. So let's do that and I'll just show you. Okay, so all you have to do is, you can just see I have the two leads here. Just put your multimeter leads on and just put them in. And you can see that right there, guys. I mean, of course, it's not going to be a lot of voltage because it's only the light bulbs in here. But yeah, there you go. And that's how you test them before to make sure that everything is working fine. Okay, I got my little butane torch. I got some solder, and I'm going to show you the positive connection and how I solder it together. I think it's a little bit unique. I'm not too sure you guys ever tried this before. This is the way I do it. You guys do it like you want. This is how I do it. Let's take a look. Well, before we get started, I'd just like to show you what I'm using. And this is just your regular butt connector. And what I do is I take the center out. And you can see on this one here where you can just cut them out. And this is what you got left here. So what I like to do is I like to put it in here like this. Just like that. Now, if you take a good look there, if this focuses in all right, you see that hole there? Well, they'll all have that hole. And that comes in for a useful purpose. And use the proper crimps here. Now, you could see that was a yellow connector and you're supposed to color match it with the yellow. But I don't color match it with the yellow because there's no casing on it. So I go to the next size up. Let me see here, right about there. So you have to push the wire in at the same time and just squeeze down, and that's it. And there is, it's on there good and solid. And now, before I go any further, of course you're gonna have to put this end in here, and you cut it to make sure that it just fits inside. You don't want it to be too long either, right? But the first thing I do is I get two pieces of shrink tubing, and I put it on this line down here first, and that's what we're going to do next. So here's just the shrink tubing here. I usually just put like a small piece, and then I'll get one just a little bit longer, and then we'll put it over top of the longest cable here, because you don't want the heat to go close to it right now because it will shrink it down. So I better put the longest one first. Put that down. Now with the next one, put it over like this. Now this time I'll put it in the connector first. Like this. Now we can put it in here, feed it in. Now that is a solid crimp on there now, and what we're going to do is we're going to put it in the vise. You can see right here, I'm going to put it in the vise. Now I'll get you set up a little bit better, and then I'll get the torch out and the solder, and we'll do this. Okay, this is about 10 minutes later. You have to make sure this is really cool to the touch, because if you try and slide that shrink tubing up there, it'll start shrinking before you get to the other side. So you got to make sure it's completely cold. So that is a nice mechanical bond with the solder and of course the inside of the butt connector. Guys, this is what I do. And I've been doing this for years and years and years, and so far it's worked out good. Now you can use electrical that electrical liquid tape if you'd like, but most of the time I buy that stuff, I use it once, and it dries out before I ever get to use it ever again, and it dries out way too fast. So I've been using this is just dielectric grease, and I'll slide the first one on here, put it right over top, just like that, and we'll get our heat gun and we'll just shrink wrap it up. And you could see where it's oozing outside there, And again, you cannot try and put another piece of shrink tubing over top until this is cooled right down. So then we'll get on to the next piece once this is cooled down. Here's the second piece. And it only takes a second or two. I don't like using an open flame, that kind of stuff. I find it's unregulated. You can't regulate it. And a lot of times you just burn it to pieces. So there you go, that's it. Now I'll show you the finished product. Well, here's the finished product. And guys, this is just regular red electrical tape. And I just put a couple of zip ties on the end there just so it doesn't unravel. And that's pretty well it. You guys let me know in the comments below if you do anything like that. And do you use dielectric grease? I'm surprised to see if anybody actually does do that. Guys, I've been doing it for years and years and years. And I figure, you know what? It seals it in there pretty good. And that's what I've been doing so far. Now, as for the panels here, another good reason why I brought the panels down lower towards the ground was cleaning them. You know, I have to get a ladder out to clean the one on top of my camp. It's way up there, like 20 feet high. This here will be so much easier. I can clean them, you know, low to the ground. It makes a huge difference in output from a dirty panel to a clean panel. So I hope you enjoyed this vid. And the next time I'm going to show the install up at the camp. Everything's just going to be plug and play, zip, zip, all go together, hopefully fast. Because you know what? When you mock something like this down here, all up, ready to go, it's gotta work when you go up there, because if it doesn't, well, it just goes sideways on you. Okay, so thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, well, you're welcome to take a look in the future again. You guys take care. Cheers.